Hello and welcome. Today I want to show you some new stuff discovered about Airlink, a new accessibility feature for colorblind people, desk tracking in V28, and some other upcoming features I haven't shown you before. Also, thank you all for subscribing. Seeing that 1000 of you enjoy my videos really means a lot to me. Let's start with the new stuff. While Oculus originally told us that Airlink would come in the V28 update, it seems like they removed it from the release, but it is still in the update. Here we have some text snippets about Airlink. I also noticed that Airlink's support page mentioned in the code, which surprisingly works, despite Airlink not even being released yet. It's interesting that it will only work on password-protected networks, and that we will have double the bitrate on Nvidia graphic cards, in comparison to AMD ones. I've previously shown you that desk tracking is coming to the Quest, and it seems like V28 finally brought it, while still hidden, to the Quest. I show you how you can get it in my old video about it, at minute 2:29. Just make sure you are on V28. I also updated my APK to V28. Here are some of the options that have been added or removed in it. Also, as some people have guessed, Oculus is internally testing so-called system teams, or in other words, light on a dark mode, nothing too special. It looks like Oculus will add a color correction feature to the Oculus Quest, which will compensate for color blindness of its users. Normal Android already has these features, but they aren't optimized for the Quest display and mess up the visuals when enabled. Oculus added their own ones as IDs 1, 2 and 3, while the normal ones are 11, 12, 13 with 0 just being a monochromatic filter. If you want to try this yourself, you'll need to execute some custom ADB commands. It's easiest to do it with SideQuest. In SideQuest, open this menu and type the following command to enable filters in general. Then you need to run the following command to specify the filter you want to enable. Just change the number at the end of it to the corresponding ID. In case you want to disable it, just type in the first command with a 0 instead of a 1. The commands are of course in the video description. Now some older stuff I have already found on April 4th, but haven't had the time to share with you all. I found out that some kind of whiteboard integration or tracking will come to the Quest. You will require a real whiteboard, but the size is customizable, similar to the couch or desk tracking feature. I guess it could be used for virtual learning or business meetings in VR. This is the corresponding settings icon, and here's a render of the 3D file I found. The last feature I want to show you is the pass-through slider we've seen in Infinite Office trailer. Thanks for watching this video, I will see you next time. And in case you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comment section.